Hancock Museum for Prisoner Movement Affairs, which is an amazing institution in place on the campus of Al-Quds University in Al-Quds East, part of Greater Jerusalem. And what happened was on my first trip to Palestine in May 2014, the last day of this trip, we went to this prison camp, which is also referred to as the Abuja House Center, because they see it as a political institution. And actually, we can work with a better English translation. They often describe themselves as the Abuja House Center for the Political Captives Movement, which actually sounds a lot more like George Jackson as well, right? So on my first trip to Palestine, on the last day, I went to this exhibition, and I told them a story that I've been telling during these 12 days. A story that connects George Jackson to an amazing Palestinian poet, Sami El-Qassam. When George Jackson was assassinated by agents of the state on August 21st, 1971, those same agents of the state raided the prison cells of the Orwellian Entitled Adjustment Center at San Quentin and looked for an explanation as to why these prisoners were able to resist this massacre in this particular way. So they went in with machine guns, looking for bodies still, and also looking for materials that could explain like why they just weren't able to kill and do nothing but kill as opposed to lose life themselves. And they did an inventory of each of these cells. And normally they found things like a half of a pencil, a bar of soap, you know, a paper clip, and this is what I see when I started digging up like some research. And when you get to the digest for the prison cell of George Jackson, there were three pages, and the first page was a list of 99 books. So these were the weapons they were looking for in this particular case. And on that particular list was a book of Palestinian resistance poetry called Enemy of the Sun. And there was no subtitle for this book on that particular list, no further identifying markers, but I know that looking through the Black Panther newspaper, I recognized this particular poem. And I started putting two and two together, and I realized that this was a particular poem that was not by George Jackson, but by Sami El-Qassam. In the Black Panther Party, someone somehow looked at the words of this poem, which might have been scribbled out on a piece of paper to share with other prisoners, other comrades, as contraband, and saw that this voice, the condition reflected in this voice, sounded like George Jackson, sounded like a Black Panther, sounded like a Black person in North America. And they made this magical mistake and published it in the Black Panther newspaper with a picture of George Jackson. This was the poetry of George Jackson, which made a lot of sense for a ton of reasons, right? When you look at a figure like Jean Genet, the French literary outlaw, who ran with both the Black Panthers and the PLO, he wrote an introduction for George Jackson's first book of letters, Soul of That Brother. That introduction was first scripted by Huey P. Newton, and they decided to use the intro by Jean Genet, which he wrote from Brazil. And it's a very famous introduction that describes the letters of Soul of That Brother, the writing of George Jackson, as a long poem of love and combat. So George Jackson had been known inside and outside of prison as a poet for quite a long time. So this mistake, if you will, makes sense for a number of different reasons. And ironically, this poem by Sami El-Qassam, which virtually every Palestinian in Palestine recognizes, it's almost like a poem by Langston Hughes, right, here. This poem went on to lead a long Black life in North America, especially via the Black Panther Party newspaper, both on the East Coast as well as the West Coast. And it went on to lead a life in different publications, not only the Black Panther Party, but publications and communiques of the Black Liberation Army as well. For decades and decades and decades, and for many people still to this day. Actually, I think the work and the trek of this exhibition is actually revealing to a number of people for the first time that this poem is not a poem of George Jackson, but a poem originally written by Sami El-Qassam, and we could argue a poem now co-authored in a very magical way by different experiences. And so this is how this particular exhibit came together. That was a story I told on my first trip to Palestine. When I told it on my last day to the folk who work at the Abu Jihad Center, they said, well, we should do an exhibit. Right? And from that moment on, I worked almost on nothing else. And it happened about 15 or 16 months later. I went back in the summer of 2015 to advance the project on the ground, as well as do a few other things. And then we agreed that I would return in October of 2015 to set up the exhibit, to launch the exhibit, to put together an opening symposium, and to also put together a series of lectures and other contact events throughout the West Bank to promote the exhibit and everything that the exhibition promotes itself. It just so happens that when I returned, there were popular uprisings and Zionist backlash. And so this is what we were working with, right, as we began to work on the exhibit. And the thing that struck me the most, probably, were the ways that the stories involved in this exhibit were taken up locally. And especially because we had two young Palestinian women, first of all, who were working on translating passages of George Jackson's text from Soul Man Brother, from Blood in My Eye, and also from some unpublished texts. And they were working on these translations, translating from English to Arabic, or what is supposed to be English, right, to Arabic, and vice versa, is much more challenging than translating between European Romance languages, right? And so we ended up with a team of maybe like four or five, like or six people working it out. But the hub of that team were two young Palestinian women students at Al-Quds University. And when I first met them upon my arrival, they both looked at me with eyes as big as flying saucers, because in the middle of this popular uprising, they were translating passages from Soul Dead Brother and Blood in My Eye. And both of them individually said to me, as soon as they met me, that everything we've been translating from these writings are things that we're living on the street, like right now. And then that set the tone for the rest of the experience of the development of this exhibit. So when the director of the Abu Jihad Museum, Dr. Fahed Abu Al-Haj, got these translated stories, like he made them his own, right? And so did other participants in the opening symposium, like Issa Karaka, who is the Palestinian Minister for Prisoner Affairs, like Sahar Francis, who's the director of Admir, a human rights and prisoner advocacy group, as well as a lecturer at Al-Quds University, Rani Jirai, who teaches the political imprisonment class at that university as well, the only one at that university as well. Everyone identified and made these stories their own. They could identify with them and vice versa. And it would go on to like carry its own like life like locally in ways that stunned me and far exceeded the expectations of that particular kind of work. And so what you see along this wall here is the closest version to the original exhibition in Abu Dis and Abu Jihad that will continue to transform as the exhibition makes its way throughout the world. And we almost took a blood oath right there, like in the museum from the very beginning, that we would basically carry this work forward, carry it internationally, take it to different places, and link it with different struggles and locally intense ways. And that's why the exhibit is not only a traveling exhibit, a reincarnating exhibit, a diasporizing exhibit, but it's also an exhibit that is a kind of changing thing. One that expands right now to intensify the original meaning by connecting here with the American Indian movement, by incorporating more Palestinian work so that we can be re-educated, we can be un-educated with respect to those particular issues and learn things that we don't know here in the same way that George Jackson became reintroduced, right, and adopted in a profound way in Palestine. And so next, we might be seeing places like Vienna, Austria. We're talking about now being incorporated to the Boston Palestinian Film Festival in the fall, discussions about Beirut, and dreams about other places too that I don't want to jinx, right? But to emphasize the point, I'd like to show you a video spliced together that also was a part of the exhibition in Abu Dis. It's a video that lifts in mixtapes and jacks and steals, right, in a revolutionary tradition. The first half of this video is taken from a film called Degrees of Incarceration, which is done by Nidal El-Azraq and Amal Bishar, friends of mine, so I stole with permission here, in advance permission, which...